She did not have a choice. It turned out, according to Miles, that Dick Rann left Sandy as soon as he found out she was pregnant. Kel surprise, Dick Rann. And I also found out that mine was not the only report where it was written that the father wanted to marry the mother. Why would they do that? To put more blame on the mother? To show the adoptive parents what I always believed, that she had a choice, and that she made the choice to give me up. I do wonder how life would have been different if I hadn't read that and believed all of that when I was age 11. So it turns out when she left Paris, she came back and she did try to keep me, but her stepfather wouldn't support her and her mother wouldn't go against him. They were more concerned with what the neighbours thought than with raising their first grandchild. So when she was 5 months pregnant, Sandy was sent to Ravensbourne Home for Unmarried Mothers, a very grim place in Bromley, Kent. On December the 30th, 1965, she was put in a taxi, sent to Bromley Hospital, where she gave birth to me on her own and wasn't allowed to hold me immediately afterwards so that we wouldn't bond. A day later, we're back at Ravensbourne, and for the next 6 weeks, we stay there together. She's allowed to feed me a tablespoon of carnation milk 5 times a day. When I'm exactly 6 weeks old, that letter goes out to Mr. and Mrs. Gallant. 2 weeks later, they come down to see me, like the look of me, take me home with them without ever meeting Sandra. And little blue-eyed, long-legged Donna Shackleton turns into brown-eyed, slightly stumpy-legged Margaret Gallant.